And this is from one of our favorite human beings.
Sarah.
Shout out to the big homies. Not the big homie, she's a homet. Sarah. She's actually like one of the originals, like hardcore.
Yep.
And she's a massive, massive Tool fan. This is Numa, but it's the Danny Carey drum thingamajiggy.
Yeah.
Danny Carey was like the first guy that was that introduced at least me to the concept of the polyrhythmic type of drumming thing that you know, whatever. Which of course I know now there are other drummers that do it, but he was like the first one when we started really getting into Tool, people were explaining stuff. And I was like, holy crap. I'm gonna be very interested to see this particular video. For time and topical political commentary, you can hit us up at Middle America with Vinny and Sorry. And if you, dear listener, would you like your song reviewed? There are multiple ways in which you can accomplish that. My favorite way is a $1 option on Patreon. You jump in, you get to meet the great Kellendross, the mighty Ian. And then you get to pull your points together. You get recruited by, you know, the great Chris Culp, all the rest of these. You pull your points together in alliance, and that determines what songs we do. Now, if you're a filthy, horrible, terrible capitalist like this one over here,
you know what you want,
and you know what you want, and you've got the privilege, what you can do is $125 helps you hop, skip, and jump in front of everybody. You go straight to the head of the line, and then you, dear listener, are able to tell us what song specifically you like to do. You get perks like being able to hear the first 40 seconds of our song.
Somebody even sent us a country song. We did that too.
We did that too.
Whatever you said,
what we did yesterday in the Underground Show. It's really, really cool. It's a good option, and you get all the perks and all that stuff. You do that 3 times, you get bumped down to the $75 rate, which is where she's at.
Talk about that baby shower.
Oh, yes, we've got a...
Not ours.
My favorite... One of my favorite human beings... Forget Villager. One of my
Our baby's coming in November.
One of my favorite human beings of all time is the big homie Ben Webb. And Ben Webb has a good friend who is in need of some assistance. So we've got their baby registry down there. So
the link will be in the description.
Link will be in the description. With that, nobody wants to hear any more from me. Let's do Tool, Numa, Danny Carey.
Here we go. Screen.
The lyrics, but I'm only going to try to focus on just the drumming here.
Oh, yeah.
I need a drummer to tell me what the hell that is.
Yeah, I know.
That sounds cool.
Fun angle.
Huh?
That's a fun angle.
You can always tell when it's a Tool song.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Feet are doing the cymbals, I'm pretty sure. Mm-hmm. But it's a different beat than...
That's crazy.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's a different time pattern, whatever. That's very hard to do.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. kidding. What is Vic Firth? Is that,
that drum
fix?
That's I don't understand how somebody can have, like, so if I'm cooking a sandwich for Vin and the kids are talking to me at the same time, that sandwich is either going to be burnt or salty. Like, I don't even understand somebody I don't understand somebody having that much, like, there were so many things. Like, sometimes both of his feet were doing something different and both of his hands were doing something different. So, like, all four at the same time.
Well, yeah, and it's not like one section is doing this over here and it's a completely different rhythm over here.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, there's only been a few times on the channel where I'm confused. So, like, the Painkiller one was one.
Mm-hmm.
I completely hated Painkiller. I completely hated the vocals. And then you played it again randomly 3 or 4 weeks later, and I was like, holy shit. This is another one of those strange moments where I'm trying to figure out. So, it's weird because I'm a lyricist first and then a guitarist second. So, when I'm looking at a song, I initially start out looking at the lyrics, right? And then it's a completely different song. So, I start with the lyrics and then, you know, and obviously if you're starting with the lyrics, then you have to basically focus on the vocalist because the vocalist is the one that's vocalizing the lyrics. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, obviously I'm interested in guitars, so I listen to guitars. And then, you know, the bass and the drums kind of like in the background.
Yeah.
But what's interesting is, like, you see how transformative the drums are for a song when we had the, you know, Sori didn't like the opening. So some of you patrons, you've heard the first 40 seconds of the song that we're doing. She was like, the riff, and then Sarcast added the drums, and then it like completely.
I'm like, you're a genius.
Yeah.
I had no idea.
But what's interesting is because the emphasis was on Danny Carey, you're starting with the drums first.
Yeah.
And then I'm hearing the guitars, then I'm hearing the vocals.
I know,
and that
yeah.
completely changes the song for me.
It was, yeah, it was weird.
That's the thing. I was like, very, very strange moment. And so I started getting confused. I was like, and then when I would hear Maynard, I'm like, oh, this is perfect. Because he was very reserved in the song. Like, it was a very, really drum-dominated song. It's not really a lyrically-dominated song or a vocally-dominant song. It was, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
So when you kind of, like, listening into it backwards, in the sense of, like, your priority of hearing or whatever, which is, like, it makes me wonder, like, these Lifetime musicians, they're able to do it front and back when they're hearing a song and whatever. But, like, that was a crazy thing for me, because then when I heard Maynard's, then you kind of understand why he was so reserved, and even the guitarist why he was so reserved, because when they came in at certain points, especially like the middle, it had that like Pink Floyd type solo thing to it. It went so perfectly.
It really did.
It is, so that's the thing that was like mind blowing to me. I'm like, that's like one of the biggest things about music that's just so crazy to me, is that it evolves in a different form. Lyrics do that too. Mm-hmm. Like, there's lyrics I've written 10 years ago that I could still, whatever, but they're like, I could still say them, but they mean something completely different. So lyrics metamorphosize too, but like, that's mind-blowing to me that...
I really liked it, go ahead, sorry.
Well, like I said, we listened to the song before, and I was like, oh yeah, it's, you know, it's good. Yeah, it's fine. You know, but it wasn't like, boom, like, you know what I mean? Like, I wasn't really a fan of this. We weren't really fans of this record. All the Tool people got mad at us.
I was just amazed at what he was doing. And some of the sounds, like you said, like this at the beginning, when he was hitting these little things, like that have the stars, or looks like stars on them, like, I don't know what those are, but that had a cool sound to it. It's amazing how many different Like, you have a drum, but there are so many different sounds that come from the different sizes and everything. Like, the way that he just put it together. First of all, so the drummer writes his own stuff when they do the song?
Oh, yeah.
That's just incredible.
Well, yeah, it's
seems
really...
like he's doing the work of two drummers.
Two or three drummers, yeah. Well, the only other time I've been, like, even close to being, was that Rush drum solo that we saw from the wrestling
band.
I think it's Neil.
Yep.
Something. Rest in peace, the big homie. But that's absolutely amazing to me. Like, if I see a guitarist and he goes crazy on a solo or whatever, I'm like, but like, this to me is like something where you look at it and you're like, I would never be able to do that.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I feel like there's five people on the planet.
Absolutely.
That can do what this guy or what the dude from Rush does.
Yeah.
Like, because it's so difficult to do that. Like, your brain is not... You know, oriented.
I said, I'm just going to sit back to and appreciate this man's talent because I will never, ever in a million years. Like, actually, some of the scale work that you were doing on the guitar today, well, it looked like scale work, but it was part of what you were doing. And I was like, oh my word, that's so fast. I was thinking, that's extremely difficult, but if I really, really wanted to do it, 100%. I could do it.
You could do it 100%.
But this?
No. You could try.
I'm gonna go watch my shows.
But initially, when we started recording this, you had the lyrics up, and I wanted the lyrics off
so we could see all the drums.
Because I just wanted to, I just wanted to start from there and go that way.
Yep. Yeah, that was a good idea.
Which is, I'm glad I did that. Well, you know, I wouldn't have done it if we would have listened to this first. If we hadn't have listened to the original first, I would have had the lyrics up there because that's my... So now I'm like, how do I find a way to balance it out so I can hear... You hear more of the instrumentation, you know, than whatever. But, man, this is a very, very... This is really, really, really good. You know, people were asking me for that. They were asking, and all the tool things, they were like, you gotta listen to this, you gotta listen to this. I was like, man... Why?
Right.
It's like, we've heard the song already.
Right.
There's nothing like, why would we do this? People were asking for it before we even did the...
Really? They were asking
for this
version.
Yeah, and then I was like, why? Like, it's him playing drums. Like, I know the guy's a good drummer, so what? But I'm actually glad that we listened to the song first and then listened to this because it's a completely different song for me, which is very, very strange. So I'm actually glad it worked out the way that it did. Holy crap, man. I still say, man, I don't know. I don't know.
What?
The only other person I can think of is that dude from Rush.
Oh.
As far as like the prowess with the instrument. Like, forget about it. I feel like it's weird. Like, the drummer in a rock band is probably the most important and yet, like, probably underappreciated.
I totally agree.
Like McGraw, for example. Like, that drummer is ridiculous. I was listening to McGraw again a couple nights ago.
He's 59 years old.
Guy's 60 years old. Jeez. I bet you anything all that work is keeping... I mean, you saw his guts.
I know, I saw his arms. I said, wow, he must have to have that to...
He's 6'5".
Well, he looked tall. He did look tall to me. And it was weird because he looked to me like he was a little bit older... No, I wouldn't have guessed 60, but he looked like he was a little bit older, but then his arms made him look younger, and so I was like, I have to know.
Yeah.
How old is this man?
Unbelievable.
That's wild. Well, good for him.
That's a 10 for me, ladies and gentlemen. It's a 10 for me. I thoroughly appreciate it. You know, this is one of, you know, I've always been, I'm going to say exactly how I feel about it. I didn't like the latest Tool record. I mean, I'm talking about, you know, the songs that we listened to. I just didn't like it, you know, or hurt people's feelings and stuff. And I'm not out there to try to be, like, controversial and give a hot take. But I'm not going to say it's cool just because it's Tool and we're fans of Tool. Like, I'm not going to do that.
Yeah.
But this, listening to it from this angle this way, I don't know.
So weird.
I might listen to the other songs now, like, with that sort of thing and see what it does.
Yeah, I guess I could go with I think I'm going to go with, like, a 9.8 on it.
Go ahead.
I was really amazed by this drum work. It was ridiculous. And I just think that... I said it at the beginning. I can't even believe that somebody can do that many things at the same time.
I know.
It's like,
and
that's
well.
A major multitasking.
And
yeah.
Well.
And I wonder, like, could he also hold a conversation while he's doing that?
It would not surprise me.
Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me either. And then the other thing that I was wondering is, does it become, you know how, like, we walk and we talk at the same time?
Right.
And that's, like, just completely normal to us? Does this kind of complexity become normal to you?
Yeah, I think you're probably right. That's like, true. That's true. The rest of us are going, ah! And he's like, what? What's the problem?
Maybe. I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's always
foolish
something.
Foolish mortal.
Focus, yeah.
Shout out to the big homie. This definitely, I'm literally going to listen to, I mean, you know, I'm not going to bore you guys with a recording of it, but I'm definitely going to be listening to the other Fear Inoculum songs again and trying to listen from the drum part first and then see what happens to it. So there you go, dear listeners.
Shout out to Tool.
Shout out to Sarah. Much love to the big homie. Vin out.
Sorry out.
Gone.